Well, hello there everyone, this is Ottomagic Critic, and welcome to my Q&A special. Unlike the previous Q&A I put into practice, I won't be speeding up the Speakonia audio file for this video, not only because it makes me sound less retarded, but there wouldn't be a need to do it thanks to me verifying my account. Alright, let's get into the questions. Alright, the first question comes from Stephen Molast Name, who asked if there was one commentary, besides episodes 1 and 2, because they are text-based, that you could redo, which one would it be? Many of them, actually. I would probably redo my commentary in Gangster Shuri Polymer and Upper Crust. A lot of the points I made were either pretty weak or tedious, and the video made it even more tedious when I was constantly responding to every single goddamn interjection Shuri Polymer made. Doodle Tones made a whole commentary in my video. It could have took a more rationally minded person who knew what he's talking about to properly analyze and take on the video given the absurdly autistic subject matter of Gangster's video. Another commentary I would like to redo would be My Nero's commentary, as well as my first Brendan Barney commentary. My Nero's Q commentary had the potential to be good, however it was wasted in the amount of jokey interjections in parts of the video that had the potential of me making a good point against his video. I was planning on commentating on Nero's second response video to Rebel Taxi, but since the video is pretty much more irrelevant than my channel, I probably won't do it, unless you guys want me to. The next question comes from QBBoy2003, who asked, have you heard of Six Inners? It's a cult on Instagram. Well, I haven't actually heard of it up until you brought it up now. Basically, it's this quote-unquote cult that once you download some app, they will hack your phone and threaten to release your personal info, unless you kill yourself. Obviously, it is absolutely disgusting and malicious. To anyone watching this, especially anyone who is young enough to be vulnerable into being manipulated into this so-called cult, I want every one of you to refrain from having anything to do with it, for your safety. The next question comes from Madison Fair, who asks, can you do more commentaries on the channel minute videos? Because the one about the LGBTQ that you did, it was a great commentary. To be honest, I have no idea, the anti-LGBT video was pretty much the only video that was something to write home about. I promised that I might do more animated storytime animated videos in the future, but who knows, maybe I might do minute videos again, if they produce something just as stupid. The next question comes from James Oliver, who asks, can you talk about the history of SPAX 3? I don't think making internet history videos is my primary specialty. From what I've heard of him, he was a Sonic fan who does reviews on video games. I've only heard of him from Jury Gorlo X's parody character Dark Emo Mario 64 making a salute commentary on him. The next 5 questions come from John the TV Show Fan 1001 Productions, who asked, can you do a commentary in Kolobi Productions? Hell yes, in fact I've been thinking about making a commentary in Kolobi for a very long time, as early as 2017. Have you seen some of his videos? His videos are so clickbaity and manufactured, it doesn't even try to attempt to hide it. At least other YouTubers try to make their content worthwhile in spite of their goal of making their videos 10 minutes long. Kolobi, on the other hand, is so cheap when it comes to having videos 10 minutes long. One good example would be his top 5 cartoon crossover cameos video, where the final 3 minutes of the video just showed a bunch of random clips and pictures of the Jimmy Neutron and Fairly Odd Parents crossover completely uninterrupted. I am not even kidding.
Peace out, guys. Have a rest and safe rest of the weekend. We'll see you guys here next time.
I mean, I can't imagine another YouTuber who cares so little about the outcome of their videos, let alone their fans. Next question from John, who do you think was the worst person to date to commentate on? I honestly have no idea, a lot of my commentaries and the people I commentate on have a special place in my heart in an odd way. But if I were to choose, I would probably pick Brendan Barney, and his video reacting to Caillou being burned in a grill. The fact that he was cheering for a fictional character to die was pretty pathetic in my opinion. Another video I would pick would be Mindshot's top 10 list of shows that should have been banned. This video was pretty opinionated for a top 10 list video, produced by a channel that's supposed to be educational. Not only that, but only serves to justify the cartoon elitist's opinions in the show. Next question from John, ever thought of using other voices in Speakonia such as Microsoft Mike? Why yes, actually, in fact there have been successful attempts at this, one of which is from my 22nd commentary. I'll promise every one of you greatly that I might be posting these videos more often, despite my lack of interest.
Damn it, Otto. Stop saying that shit. You know you are not going to actually do it cause you're a lazy thug.
Shut the fuck up, nobody cares about your stupid fucking opinion. Well, expect at least, 5 commentaries planned so far. I have multiple voices stored into my computer, and I am planning to use some of them. I am also hoping that I can get some Macintosh voices. If anyone has a link to any of them, please let me know, it would be greatly appreciated. Next question from John, what do you hate more, Loud House or Steven Universe? To be honest, I don't really hate either of those shows as much as I used to, because I think these two shows are harmless despite their dipshit fanbase. I haven't watched either of those shows for a long time, so, if I were to choose which is worse, it would be a question of which fanbase is the worst, because nowadays we seem to love judging the overall content of the show just from the fanbase alone and nothing else. I am pretty sure I am at a loss with this question. And last question from John, favorite Nicktoon? I think we can all agree that SpongeBob would be it. SpongeBob has been with me for a very long time. I even like a bunch of other Nicktoons such as Rocko's Modern Life, Invader Zim, Hey Arnold, Renny and Stimpy, Fairly Odd Parents, among other Nicktoons that I couldn't be arsed to name here. The next four questions come from Charlotte Ridby, who asks, who is the most stupidest person you have ever met on the internet? Pretty tough question, fam. Throughout my existence in the internet I think I encountered a whole assortment of stupid people. I may not like someone, but sometimes I wouldn't think they are stupid. For a time I didn't like Amazing Flying Kirby due to his actions, but he knows how to manage an entire army of sock puppet accounts to troll and harass people online, so I wouldn't call him stupid, if he has that skill. If I were to choose, I would probably pick the less talented goth-eggs who try to act mature but end up in the vacuous waste of goth-eggetry. I know, it might not be that much, but I do believe there are worse people out there, but I would place them in the just plain malicious category rather than stupid. One can't be the dumbest person online and be malicious at the same time. Next question from Charlotte, what got you to start YouTube? What got me to start YouTube was a pretty long journey, if you ask me. During my Going Ape misadventures, I was already getting into the whole commentary scene in 2014. I was inspired by a lot of commentators from the likes of Jury Gorlorex, Youngblood Fantasy 91, Eddie the Scammer, PitRox 56, Super Epic Clay, Lance 1000, and, I should you not, Foxtrot Delta Lima 497, among others. Now, say what you will about some of those commentators now, but these commentators inspired me to get into the whole commentary community pipeline. In fact, the whole Frozen 99 swell persona on GoAnimate was a troll from the very beginning. I saw PitRox response videos in Gumball 99 swell, who according to him was a Gumball fantart at the time, who will defend the DD show to the tip. I wanted to make a version of Gumball 99 swell and make it a Frozen fantart, because I wanted to imitate the amount of fantartery from the GoAnimate community over that movie. I made a series of videos out of Deepwood Soul trolling him, who was infamous by the GoAnimate community for daring to make culling videos out of Elsa. What nerve. Over time, I decided to dump the whole Frozen fantard persona and start taking it to a whole new direction. Around the same time, I saw that many GoAnimators such as Kidiminic 9000, Carl Nenbury and Chill and they adopt the commentary techniques, and made a series of videos on GoAnimate videos, many of which revolve around the good user versus bad user nonsense. When Kevin made a commentary in the classic Music Lover 1999, who is now known as Painkiller 99, it inspired me to shut up and make my own commentaries, which is when I made my first commentary. Now, unlike the so-called mature users of today, the GoAnimate commentators at that time weren't fucking morons. In fact, most of them come from the Knott's Nerd school of the GoAnimate community, which is pretty much the last place in the GoAnimate community where there's actual sanity left. The rest is just where intelligence goes to die. Next question from Charlotte, what YouTuber do you like the most? Well, it's no one in particular, but I tend to like a lot of commentary YouTubers, political YouTubers, history YouTubers and some electronic YouTubers, many of which such as PewDiePie, Silva Gunner, Great Gay Andre, Doodletones, Bosch, BSA Sitch, Cute Fuzzy Weasel, No Funkers, Pure Cynical among others. I am sorry for not giving a straightforward answer, but I don't really know if I can rank a lot of YouTubers in some hierarchy, since I am indulged with new types of videos every day, so it's impossible to keep track. Last question from Charlotte, have you ever experienced a Karen in the outside world yet? No, not recently, but I had known people who told me their experiences. The next two questions come from Opinion Respecter, who asks, which commentary would you say you're the most proud of? Well, it's nothing in particular, a lot of my commentaries back in the day were a mixed bag to say the least. If I were to choose, it would be a tie between my commentary in Megaduke, my commentary in Minute Videos, my Matthew Davis commentaries, and my Brendan Barney and Logamax commentaries. Don't worry, there are a lot more commentaries I am proud of, but I am proud of these commentaries not only because of how spot in some of them were for their time, but also for their reception. They have attracted a great deal of people to watch my content, which would encourage me to do more. Next and final question from Opinion Respecter: how did you discover the Go Animate community? I believe I discovered Go Animate videos when I was a kid. I probably discovered it in 2011 to 2012, if I am wrong. I discovered them after watching a few Smosh videos back in the day, because it's 2011, it's part for the core to be into Smosh back then, and I discovered a Go Animated version of one of their videos titled, If Kids Shows Were Real. Go Animate used to have this Happy Bunny theme, which was used to make that video. I tried it out for myself, but unfortunately I didn't have an account back then, so all I can really do was play around with the default flashcard themes that the website provided if you don't have an account. You guys probably know what I am talking about. But later on, I created my own account in 2012, and made a few videos that barely hit one view. Mainly my videos consists of stick figures fighting, Comedy World people reenacting some of the Flipnotes I saw before then. I even had some Lil Peeps videos and Cartoon Classics videos in the mix as well, and overall just your usual run-of-the-mill Go Animate videos. My videos were all titled in English, and they were poorly translated might I add, because I just moved to America 2 years before. Surprisingly, this was before me knowing about grounded videos. All I knew from Go Animate was the videos that appeared in the staff pick. I made my own grounded videos myself, and it's usually consistent of some kid killing Barney and dead meat videos. That's pretty much it really. With me knowing about grounded videos, the pipeline took me to the first instances of good user versus bad user schisms that took place between Memmy9909 and the Super Baxter. Memmy has been notorious for supposedly stealing other ideas from other grounded video makers. To be honest, this is no different from the usual Go Animate grounded video maker of today. Just a little update, the whole squabble between Memmy9909 and the Super Baxter runs a lot deeper, because Memmy not only steals grounded videos, but he claims that they aren't his own and claims that others are stealing from him. Yeah, not a good person. And many Baxter fans retaliated and made videos out of Memmy9909. Memmy then retaliated and made grounded videos out of those users, which is pretty much where the whole shiflinging began. I am just going to leave it right here. Maybe I might make a separate video on what happened afterwards. The next 5 questions come from KensterTube, who asks, are you going to join Flare? If so, what videos do you think you should commentate on from Flare or Vigly for that matter? Well yes, I've been thinking of joining Flare, because I believe some of the YouTube offshoots deserves a chance to shine. Also, I don't think there is a lot of videos from Flare that are worth a commentary, since I believe that Flare isn't as cancerous as BitChute. My god, don't even get me started in BitChute. That website is packed full of conspiracy theorists, Holocaust deniers, neo-Nazis, Trumptards, QAnon fags, and just the usual amalgamation of craziness that has festered for the past 4 years. It's a pretty cancerous cesspool. Next question from KensterTube: what are your thoughts on cancel culture? I think cancel culture is cancerous personally. I think cancel culture for the most part is pretty stupid as well, like many of you out there. However, I do believe that so-called cancel culture can have some sort of positive. If you want to cancel someone because you found out they were child molesters or just monsters, and you want to cut off their sphere of influence in the public, I wouldn't have a problem with canceling them, to be honest. However, this is where my agreement with cancel culture pretty much ends. Most of the reasons for canceling other people stems from either jumping to conclusions or just ruining the lives of unimportant people for making a racist joke a few years ago. For instance, many K-pop stans try to cancel Jaji because they found out that he played a character called Filthy Frank, which is filled with crude humor and politically incorrect jokes. These K-pop stans weren't familiar with this type of humor, and they think this is enough to cancel him, as if it's defined by his overall behavior and character. This is far from the truth, because his description clearly states that Filthy Frank is the embodiment of everything a person should not be, and is a deliberate and unapologetic parody of the whole social media machine and a reflection of the human microcosm that social media is. Remember PewDiePie? Remember, when he was constantly smeared by mainstream media and cancel culture Twitter? Just imagine, if someone like Filthy Frank and Leafy were the most subscribed people on the platform. Cancel culture media would have a fucking field day over these people. There would be news publications calling these two Nazis, which will lead people to think that they are on their side, which will lead RedTube to make videos calling them Nazis even more, and it'll just be a large cancerous battlefield of shitty opinions and ideas. Yep, cancel culture is a cesspit, and it stems from the whole SJW microcosm. However, the right is no better in this regard, because they will just use this phrase as a means to demean any legitimate ideas relating to having other people held responsible for what they believe. Next question from KensterTube. What are your thoughts on Encyclopedia Dramatica? Encyclopedia Dramatica is pretty much a guilty pleasure for me. Sure, there are some genuine assholes who edit that website who will dox people to get back at them, and they doing right horrible things which I highly disavow for obvious reasons, but there are some articles on Dramatica that genuinely make me laugh, and you can learn some new information about someone, and this is all from experience reading about people I know such as Curie Gorlox and what have you. I hope one day I will get an Encyclopedia Dramatica page about me so I can have my reputation tarnished. Next question from KensterTube. What was your least favorite commentary? My least favorite commentary would be a tie between my classic music lover 99 video, as well as my gangster Suri Polymer and Upper Crust video. These videos weren't that great, even if we considered that these were just old videos, and I had to start somewhere. But still, these were old videos, so we had to start somewhere, right guys? Next and final question from KensterTube. What would your reaction be if you saw Ascension ice cream cone that has your face on it? I would probably appoint myself to my local psychiatric ward after finding out that my schizophrenia is so severe that not even the Seroquel medication that I was prescribed couldn't help my sanity, and I will be spending the rest of my life in said psychiatric ward. The next question is from Hazy, who asks, is Ottomagic Critic underrated? I don't know, I think it depends on who you ask. Many people who have more subscribers than me would call me underrated, because they are part of a much larger community, and they also find me appealing, while people who have less subscribers and part of the same microcosm as I am would call me overrated, because they don't like me. If I were to decide for myself on whether or not I am underrated, I would say yes, because there are many people who have more subscribers than me, and if they like my content, they would find me underrated. It all depends on subscriber base, and whether one likes you or not. The next three questions come from Eddie Wise, who asks, why did you make three commentaries on me? How I discovered your videos in the first place was from a person in MegaDupe's Discord server. The person was sharing a link of your video on why people should stop ranting on Mr. Enter. Knowing me, I decided to make a commentary on it. I made two more commentaries on you, because I wanted to respond to your points. Next question from Eddie Wise, what is going to happen to your channel in the near future? I don't know, I might make more commentaries in certain things. I might make one on Kolobi Productions, who was brought up by John a few questions back. I don't exactly know what my channel would look in the near future, however it's good to try out different things. And last question from Eddie Wise, are you voting for Biden or Trump? I probably won't be voting for either of them. Donald Trump has been doing jack shit about the pandemic and instead wastes his time in the culture war, and Joe Biden is just a dementia-ridden status quo figure, and the status quo is what got us Donald Trump in the first place. Donald Trump's attacks against Joe Biden are trash too. He thinks that Joe Biden is a radical leftist who wants to abolish the police. I mean, Joe Biden wrote the crime bill, so he would be the last person to do it all, so what the fuck? The next three questions come from Cartoon Boy 03 Productions, who asked, favorite Cartoon Network show? I think my favorite Cartoon Network show would be Regular Show, Samurai Jack, Teen Titans, and Ed, and Eddie. I have multiple shows from Cartoon Network I really like, so I can't really pick out my absolute favorite in particular. Next question from Cartoon Boy, what are your thoughts on Kiwi Farms? Kiwi Farms is basically the less mean version of Encyclopedia Dramatica. It's a forum website, where it talks about various different lolcows, as well as various things they said and did. There is some very funny and useful information in Kiwi Farms. Next question from Cartoon Boy, what do you think about the current state of YouTube? I think the current state of YouTube is starting to get a little better, but that's not saying much. I haven't heard much about YouTube being subservient to blue checkmark online journalists, intentionally or otherwise, fucking over users by slandering big YouTubers like PewDiePie as much, and I've seen that YouTubers who actually care about their work are getting more rewarded by the algorithm. I don't know, let's hope for the best. The next six questions come from Spacey McSpacer, who wanted to ask these questions for a while. He asks, what inspired you to make commentaries in the first place? Once again, how I got into commentaries was back in 2014, before I got started with my main GoAnimate account in 2014. I wanted to make my own commentaries from then on. My motivation for commentaries reached its peak when I created my first YouTube account, as well as seeing the anime-type people, not the mature user. Though commentators, don't worry, making commentaries and rants related to Go Animate that far exceeds the cognitive ability of the Go Animate community at that time. Next question from McSpacer: how do you come up with your OC that you use in your videos? My OC is based on a 1980 arcade game known as Berserk, which is a game where you go around a maze shooting robots. The main antagonist, coincidentally enough, is named Evil Otto, and has been a subject in video game lore and controversy. It has been reported that 3 people died from playing this game, but people are convinced that these deaths are intrinsic with the game being embedded with some curse. Now, we all know that these theories revolving around the game being embedded with a curse is probably bollocks, but the overall game as well as the legend is pretty interesting to say the least. I wanted Otto to be my OC, not only because of name similarities, but I want this to be intrinsic to my overall personality, in the sake knowing the legend behind it. Next question from McSpacer: what do you think of Modern Bracket Neutron 37? Modern Bracket is improving a lot, like me. Granted, he did say some rather questionable things, like this one.
Oh, and quit trying to cheat the system so PewDiePie keeps being the most popular YouTuber. It's inevitable YouTube will crack down on this practice eventually by removing potential fake subscribers. Just because T-Series also cheats doesn't give you the blessing to do the same for Pewds.
I don't know about you guys, but I always thought that the subscribe to PewDiePie thing was a fun campaign that pretty much united the entire YouTube community, left, right, and center, but apparently Bracket Neutron took one of the means of contributing to it as some sort of criminal offense, and enabled YouTube to intervene and punish PewDiePie. Oops. While I disagree with that sentiment, I am a great friend of his nonetheless. Next question from McSpacer: do you think the user groups or mature users are lost causes at this point? I do believe some of them are, to be honest. Say what you will about the mature users, but at least some of them are genuinely trying to improve, and not be an innocuous microcosm that the user groups possess, but 9 times out of 10, they don't. If these so-called mature users are above the age of 14, then I believe that they are on a lost track in improving. I've talked to many of these mature users and user group members, and it feels like talking to a brick wall. Next question from McSpacer: what types of YouTube videos do you watch in your spare time? Sometimes I would watch some gameplay videos, as well as some old videos from my friends. I even watch some commentary videos. And final question from Spacey McSpacer: did you ever think about making rants? Yes, in fact I made a few quick rants before, and I might be doing more of them in the future. Mike Manners 11 asks, are you down to play Wii games online with me? Oh, I wish, but my Wii is not connected to the internet, nor is it set up now. My Wii controller doesn't have any batteries either. First of all, I really enjoy your videos, as they are entertaining as fuck. Thank you, girl a purple heart. Anyways, here are the questions. First question being, what are your thoughts on YouTube poops? I like YouTube poops. They are a transformative medium that is potential of great things to be made. Lots of memes are pretty much branches of the YouTube poop subculture. Next question from girl a purple heart, what is the worst commentary video you ever did? My least favorite commentary would be a tie between my classic Music Lover 99 video, as well as my Gangster Suri Polymer and Upper Crust video. These videos weren't that great, even if we considered that these were just old videos, and I had to start somewhere. But still, these were old videos, so we had to start somewhere, right guys? I would probably say that my Nero's Q commentary is one of my weaker commentaries. It had the potential to be good, but my audio was too fast, I made some stupid points that made no sense, my jokes were lame, and it was just a mess. I might make a revamped version of it to make it better. Yep, I wish I had more, but that's all that I can come up with. Happy videoing, man boy. Colon P, thanks girl a purple heart, you are very beneficial for analytics for female viewership. Wait, that's kind of sexist. The next question comes from Zero, also known as Panda Darling Sue, who asks, do you have a favorite music artist or music genre? One of my favorite genres would include rock and synth pop, and some unconventional music such as vaporwave and future funk. There are many more types of music that I like. The next 3 questions come from Natishifu, who asks, what was your biggest inspiration to make commentaries? Once again, I already answered this one, so I will just leave it at that. Next question from Natishifu, who had to be the most laughable person you ever commentated in? I would probably say Eddie Wise, because it's his video telling people to stop making rap videos on Mr. Ender. He was posing as this reasonable person making rational points against Mr. Ender's critics, but then his mask just slipped off and said that making rap videos on him hurts his feelings, and we should apologize. On top of all that, he said that he will call the police should anyone make a rap video on him. The video serves as a reminder that there is no true defender of Mr. Ender that isn't overly emotional and childish. I can't really say the same thing about my two other videos on him, because it's essentially the video equivalent of beating a dead horse. Another laughable person I commentated would be Mark Collett and Maddie's Modern Life, and their videos in some of them chip commercials. These videos serve to represent the irony of the anti-SJW community. They claim to be the least offended people on the planet, when they act like fucking chimps over gay people and black people being in their commercials. Yep, such champions of the free marketplace of ideas, fucking morons. And last question from Matishifu, who was your biggest inspiration for animation? I do believe my inspiration for animation started off when I made a few flipnotes. I believe everyone else had the exact same experience. The next question comes from Alan the Memkid, who asks, what's your opinion on Beyond nowadays? Once again, I don't take GoAnimate. In fact, I think it's the best animation software for its kind compared to Pautuma and Floatagon, but I hate this good user versus bad user bullshit that has festered the community, and unfortunately some of my subscribers have that mentality. GoAnimate has the potential to be a great animation software for storytelling and creativity, but these kids are wasting all of it through meaningless garbage and repetitive video making. Next question comes from Alex Hecht, who asked, do you think I am a better person than I was in 2016? I do believe so. I've never seen you taking trolls seriously, whether they're on your side or not. You are not acting like a dick to anyone, and despite you acting better than you did and proving it, you haven't joined the false mature users, who call themselves so but they still engage in the same type of belligerency the good users have, so I believe you are on the right track. The next 12 questions come from Mike the Koopa Warrior, who asks, were object shows a mistake? And what is the worst object show you've ever seen? I don't think object shows were a mistake, they are pretty harmless to say the least. And I don't know which is the worst one, because I don't watch them as much. But I've seen some poorly made ones as well, and at worst they are just a still frame, while the characters talk, or maybe that's just a vague memory of one of them. Next question from Mike, what do you think of these ALM protests? I support their message of emancipation in the black community, however some people are just using them as an opportunity to loot and destroy property for no reason, whether or not they stand by what they are fighting for at all. In fact, there's been leaders of the protests trying to prevent looting from happening. Regardless of what Fox News tries to tell you, Mike, most of the demonstrations have been peaceful, but there's been police that have been trying to take them down simply for demonstrating. I am not going to ditch fighting social injustice just because some dumbass decided to do bad stuff in Target. Next question from Mike, is the GoAnimate community declining? I guess, because barely anyone is using GoAnimate, because the means of doing so is pretty much impossible. But, there are still people carrying on the culture of GoAnimate in spite of its inaccessibility today. Next question from Mike, what would happen if CanEye won the election? I have no idea, we would probably get stupid policies that are reinforced by neoliberal policies. I am not sure. Okay, the next 8 questions is seemingly just filler spam. Number 5, beware the French fries. By eating those oven chips would mean the destruction of our glorious ethno-pluralist Western civilization, where national socialism is its founding principle. Number 6, what is the best rapper alive? I like the ones with peanuts. I am not much of a fan of eating the actual rapper, but rather what is wrapped in the wrapper. Who the fuck in their right mind would eat the rapper? Number 7, and no, I am never going to enunciate that naughty word, you racist pieces of shit. Number 8, wanna go on failure adventures? No, due to the global health pandemic and the risk getting myself COVID-19 and potentially killing myself, I think I'll pass. Number 9, best meme. I don't know, I think I enjoy all memes equally. Number 10, Group Pickles is God. Yes. Number 11, insert irrelevant 1000 degree knife joke here. I cut myself with a knife, and as it turns out I am made out of cake throughout all this time. And last filler question in Mike's ultimate masterpiece he's been willing to share with me for a long time, do the Wiggles dominate the boss baby? God damn it, Mike, please don't put that cursed image in my brain, I mean Jesus Christ. The next five questions come from BracketNewTrump37, who asks, is Ginkgo the essence of life? Yes, I breathe, eat, and shit Ginkgo every day, and I recently slaughtered a goat in the petting zoo and grew a pentagram with its blood and summoned Ginkgo, and he has told me to acknowledge the existence of broken families and buy McCain's oven chips. Next question from Bracket, do you feel like the cartoon community has improved over the last couple years? I think so. Many cartoon reviewers I follow, such as Saber Spark and Rebel Taxi, are doing fine right now. I think the cartoon community has learned its lesson from Mr. Enter-type puritanism that made the community look frivolous and stupid from the get-go. I don't know, what do you guys think? Next question from Bracket, favorite music, like preferred genre or albums? I answered this one, so I am going to leave it at that. Next question from Bracket, hate to be that guy, that's alright buddy, but any thoughts in my artwork? I like your artwork, but I am just wondering if you are going to do anything with them, like putting them in a cartoon or comic. Because all I am seeing really is just a bunch of concept art when there is a whole lot of potential for them. And last question from Bracket, are there any kinds of aesthetics, visual or otherwise, you enjoy or vibe with? Greek and Roman statues, Windows XP aesthetics, Nintendo Wii aesthetics, logos from the 1980s, old comics from the late 19th and early 20th century, I can go on. The next two questions come from Wilkin SpongeBob, who asks, what is your favorite Cartoon Network show? I answered this one, so I will just leave it at that. Next question from Wilkin SpongeBob, what is your opinion on Hi-Hi-Po-Fi-Mi-Umi show? I have never watched the Hi-Hi-Po-Fi-Mi-Umi show, but I have heard some positive things about the band it's based on. The next question comes from Shotoku Legend, who asks, what do you use to edit your videos? I use Windows Live Movie Maker, I use it to commentate on videos for my series. You can't get more basic than Windows Movie Maker, and look how my later videos turned out. I've been experimenting with other programs, you can see some time ago that I've experimented with Sony Vegas, as well as the older version of Windows Movie Maker. The next two questions come from RainbowDoodler209, who asks, what's your favorite thing to do offline? I like going to various different places when I am offline, but unfortunately given the situation we are all in, I can't do it that much without being at risk of catching that disease. Next question from RainbowDoodler209, why do you put jump scares in some of your videos? Asking out of curiosity. Keep in mind, I like getting spooked. I have no idea what you're talking about, because I barely remember putting jump scares in my videos. If there is any examples, I would like to hear them so I can do more of it in the future. What? The next four questions come from Gibson Chaos, who asks, what Windows version you like? Well, I like the versions of Windows that I've used, such would be Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8.1, and the version that I am using, Windows 10. Even though I haven't used all of the Windows operating systems, I like them all equally, for they are very fun to learn about. There is an entire genre of videos called Windows Destruction, where you basically fuck around with these operating systems. Next question from Gibson, do you like cats? Yes, I do. In fact, I've had some cats in my life, and even my girlfriend's relative has cats of her own. Next question from Gibson, is your enemy in jail? Who's my enemy? Oh, you mean morals, yes, critically, and cartoons, no? Well, no, morals is not in jail, he's doing just fine. And last question from Gibson, do you use Vegas Pro? Yes, sometimes I do for experimental purposes. However, the version I am using doesn't work anymore, and I am planning on getting a new one. If anyone has a link to download it, please share it with me in the comments. The last three questions come from Nintendo to DS Extra Large Owner, who asks, is Desmond the Potato going to dominate the human race? Who the hell is Desmond the Potato? Why should I be concerned about his voyage of conquering and enslaving the human race should I know about him? Next question from Nintendo, have you seen Freedom Tunes? Yes, I've seen his videos, most of which are just there to strum on the left, but I still subscribe to him for some reason. Even though there are some videos of his I disagree with, his videos are pretty entertaining for what they're worth. Last question from Nintendo, have you seen NPC University? It's a YouTube series by MeMeMeme. I used to be a watcher and subscriber of MeMeMeme, but later on I personally view him as just boomer propaganda. It just seems like the only purpose of his channel is just to parrot some talking points Donald Trump and Fox News will tell you, which is probably why he accepts the narrative that Joe Biden is Antifa for some reason, and that Bernie Sanders is a natural communist.
Now, for those of you who think it's hypocritical that I engage in a capitalist system while claiming to be a socialist, let me just offer some assurance by saying that that's a good thing. Or at least it is if you're rich.
The channel is just the animation equivalent of your grandparents telling you about what they saw on Fox News, and how great Donald Trump is. I might make a video in the channel later down the line. Okay, so that concludes the very exciting Q&A special for you guys. And please note, this is not a Q&A submission video, so please don't post comments down in the comment section for the purposes of the new Q&A video. Anyway, this is Ottomagic Critic, and I'll see you next time.